Hello, so we will be studying a practical implementation of dining philosopher's problem here in this lecture. So last time we have studied the theoretical concept of dining philosopher problem. So this is a dining philosopher problem. We have studied this with five number of philosophers, P0 to P4, and five chopsticks, CH0 to CH4. P0 is requiring CH0, CH1, P1 is requiring CH1, CH2. Similarly, P4 is requiring CH4 and CH0. And these philosophers are going through different states like hungry, eating, and thinking. Okay, so we have to solve this problem using a semaphore and a C program. Okay, so let us try to understand the main function. So we have declared here a semaphore variable for chopstick because chopstick is a shared resource. So this shared resource, if it is with one of the philosopher, then another should remain in the waiting state. So this we are implementing with the binary semaphore. So we are declaring this chopstick array of 5 here. Then we want to create the 5 threads for each philosopher. So here first we are initializing the semaphore variable. So initialization have function is same underscore init. And it has these 3 arguments. So address of semaphore variable. Next is whether it is shared or not. So if it is 0, that means it is not shared to other process. And last is its initial value. So your chopstick is going to be with either of 2 philosophers. So between 2 philosophers, one chopstick is shared. So if it is with one philosopher, another should remain in the waiting state. So it has initial value as 1. So its value will change from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. So 1 means it is available, 0 means it is not available. So here we have initialized the semaphore variable. Then we will create 5 threads for philosopher function. So this is a definition for creating threads, pthread underscore create, whose arguments are address of thread variable. Then next is attributes. So attributes we are assigning default attributes. Then next is name of the function or start routine. And last is the value that we are going to pass to this function. And last, we are joining this function. So this function is a cancellation point and therefore not marked with a throw. So this function is used to join the different threads. So if you don't use this function, then what will happen? Even though all the threads have not completed their task, then also your program will terminate. So in order to continue your program, with all the threads execution, you have to write this as a join function. So let us write a definition for this function. Void star philosopher. So its definition should be void star philosopher. So let us try to write. Okay, so this is a void star philosopher. It has one argument. So that argument is, let us write this argument as void star arg. So it has always argument of type void star. Okay, so first task we do in every function is that we typecast the value that is passed to this function into an integer value, so long int. And we are taking a long int because void star is of 8 bytes and long int is also 8 bytes. If you take int only, then it will give you the warning that you are converting 8 bytes of data into 4 bytes of data. So that's why we are taking it as a so we are not named this variable long int num equals to okay, so we have just converted this value. Then next, whenever a philosopher will enter here, at that time he will have some state. So we will keep a track of the state of the philosopher with a status array, character array status, so that it write a size of 6 and initialize it to initially 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So initially all the philosopher will have no state, neither hungry nor eating nor thinking. So this we have initialized here. Okay, and whenever the philosopher will enter this routine, so the philosopher in hungry state. Or just write, philosopher is hungry. And he wants to eat. So whenever the philosopher is hungry, we will make its status as status. So the index will be num, that is number of philosopher. And his status will mark as H. So he is in the hungry state. And when he is in the hungry state, so he will try to acquire the chopstick. So acquire the left and right chopstick. So what is the function to acquire the chopstick? So it will decrement the semaphore value when he is using the common shared resource. So same underscore weight. And here you will write the chopstick, sorry, address of chopstick, left will be num. And one more chopstick he is requiring, so same underscore weight and the address of chopstick num, here we should write a square bracket, it is a array index, so that's why it was giving the error. Okay, so next is num, let me write a formula for this. Let us check here. P0 is requiring num. Num means 0 here and 0 here. So it is same that P0 is requiring a 0 chopstick and the first chopstick. P1, CH1 and CH2. P2, CH2 and CH3. P4, CH4 and CH0. So this is important to understand. CH4 and CH0. So this formula you can write as, it requires num and num plus 1. Num and num, sorry, num and num plus 1 and mod 5. Why mod 5? Because the last philosopher CH4 is requiring the chopstick number 4 and a 0, not 4 and a 5. So that's why mod 5 is required here. Okay, so this will acquire the chopstick, then he will require some time to eat. So we will give this time to him by using a slip system call. So slip 1. So here now philosopher is eating. So as he is eating, so we will assign a state here. So we will write this here. And here we will change the status of philosopher, status of num equals to what? Eating. So philosopher is now eating. So status of num will become equals to E. Okay, so after he finishes his eating, then what will happen? After the philosopher finishes his eating, then he will try to, he will release the chopstick. So he will here release chopstick. So which function is used to release the chopstick? Same underscore post. So same underscore post just increments the value of semaphore variable. Initially it was 1. So this function is making it as a 0. This function is making it as 0 for the next chopstick. And now whenever he is releasing the chopstick, that means you have to again make that value equals to 1. So address of chopstick, so release the chopsticks in the reverse order of acquiring num plus 1 mod 5. So first we are releasing the right chopstick and then we will release the left chopstick. Address of chop of num. Am I right? Is a spelling correct? Yes, but here I have given a dollar. Okay. address of chopstick num. Okay, so this will end your function and say pthread underscore exit arguments null, default attributes. We have created the thread with default attributes, so we'll exit with the default attributes only. Okay. So this completes your function. So we are going to modify this still, but we will check the output meanwhile. So when the philosopher will release the chopstick, at that time the philosopher will go in the third step that we have not written, that philosopher is thinking. Okay, and we will make change the status of philosopher num equals to T, thinking means a T. Okay, so H means hungry, E means eating, and T means thinking. Okay, now we have to print this status. For displaying the output, we should have some output. So for that reason, we will call a function as print status. So whenever we are changing the state, at that time we will call this function print status. So here also we will call the print status, and after changing the state here, we will call the print status function. Okay, now let us write the definition of this print status function. So print status opening bracket, sorry, print status . So here you have to simply print the status of the philosopher. So we'll write a for loop for that. So first we'll print a new line so that every line will print on the new line. So slash n. So just copy this. And then you have to print the status array. So status array is of 5 characters. 6th one will be backslash 0. So here I will write a for say I equals to 0 I less than 5 I plus plus, and declare this I variable here. It is showing a error, so we will first declare it. No semicolon at the end, loop is continuing, and here we will print. What you should print? The status or percent C. So we will give some spaces here, 3 spaces, comma, comma what? Status array, status of I. Okay, so this completes your print status function. But your table should have the heading or the title bar. So this bar we will print in the main function. So let us try to print the title bar here. We will print it here. For I equals to 0, I less than 5, what will be the title bar? So it will be, let me delete, P bracket percent D, P percent D, and here we will just print I value, LD value, sorry, I value, and here it should be LD, percent LD, because we have taken I as a long int, so that's why it should be LD. Okay, so this will print the headings of your table. Let us print this on the new line. Save this program. And let us try to execute the program. So name of the program is dp1. So gcc dp1.c and link the thread library pthread.h. So it is showing some warning for return type defaults to int print status. and one warning for a slip function. So it is giving some error here. Printf p percent ld comma I. So this LD we have taken as integer. So what is the warning? Let me check again. Line number 8, return type by default to int print status. First try to remove that warning. Line number 8. So it should have a void return type. It is not returning any value, so it has a void as a return type. And second warning is slip. So slip, we have to include the header file, so we will include one header file for slip is hash include unistd.h. td.h. Okay, so let us check again. Cannot find minus lp thread.h. Sorry, minus lp thread. Okay, now it's okay. gcc dp1.c minus lp thread. Take the output dot slash a dot a dot out. Okay, so we have missed this indexes. Every index is printing on the new line, so it should not be on the new line. Let us remove the slash n from main function. So this should not be slash n here. Rather, you can print a slash n here, because if you are printing in the for loop, then for every value it will print the slash n. So that's why it was printing p0, p1, p2 on the new line. So let us try to execute, compile this again. You have made the changes. Okay, so now it is printing the values, but table indices are not clearly aligned. So we will try to align those indices. So status array, where we are printing here, so give some extra spaces here so that it will be good. Okay, now it is aligned good, but let us take output again one more time. So you will get a different output in every scenario. So this is not matching exactly. So we'll try it one more time. Because threads are executing simultaneously, so that's why it is giving you a problem in printing this as an output. Let us try to minimize the spaces that we have given. Two spaces, so we'll not give a space here, okay, or single space here, and then we'll remove some spaces from here also. Okay, so let us try one more time. Okay, now we have got a little good output here. So let us check this output. So Pilasopar P0 is entering into the hungry state, then he is starting immediately eating. And when Pilasopar P0 is in the eating state, this P1, if you observe, P1 is always in the waiting state. That means he is in the hungry state. He can't it simultaneously with the P0, because P0 has acquired his one of the chopstick. But P2 can start the eating, and when P2 is in the eating state, then P1 and P2 will remain in the waiting state. Okay, now here P0 has released his chopstick, and whenever he has released the chopstick, P4 have started eating. Similarly, here once this P2 releases the chopstick, that means once he goes in the thinking state, at that time P1 is eating here. And whenever this P4 is releasing the chopstick, at that time this philosopher is going into the eating state. So that means our program is working fine. Okay, now let us try to demonstrate deadlock here. So what is a deadlock that we have seen? So deadlock is nothing but every philosopher is acquiring one of the chopstick, and remaining everyone is waiting for each other. P0 will be waiting for P1, P2, P3, P4. So how we can demonstrate this in our program? So let us demonstrate this. So this can be demonstrated here as, so if he is acquiring this first chopstick, we are giving some delay here to acquire this second chopstick, so that meanwhile some other philosopher will come and will acquire his second chopstick. So similarly, every philosopher in this way will get one chopstick. So we have just provided a slip of one here, and let us check a program again. Now what will be the output? It should go into the deadlock. So all the philosophers here are in the hungry state, and now it is not making any progress. No, none of the philosopher is going into the eating state, and this will remain infinite time here in the waiting state. All the philosophers will remain in the waiting state, and none of the thread will get terminated. Okay, so this is a deadlock. Okay, now we have to remove this deadlock also. So let us understand how this deadlock can be removed. So even if there is some delay here, we need to solve this problem also. So for solving this problem, we will take another semaphore variable. Let us name this as same_t, mutex. Okay, so same_t, mutex. And initialize this semaphore variable here. So the same function that we will use for initialization. So same_t, name of the variable is mutex. Okay. So this below line we have just printing, let me write printing heading of table. Okay, now what we have done, we have used mutex variables to lock and unlock the critical section. So here, whenever is the philosopher is in the hungry state and he wants to acquire the chopstick, when one philosopher is acquiring the chopstick at that time, use mutex variable to lock the critical section. That means if one philosopher is trying to acquire the chopsticks, he should acquire both. It should not be the case that he has acquired one and then another is coming in and he is acquiring the second. So that way you will get a deadlock. So here we are making or solving this problem using a mutex variable. So write this as address of mutex here, and the same thing you will do after releasing the chopstick, that you will unlock. So where you will unlock this? So you will unlock this after releasing the chopsticks. So here you will unlock. And what is the function for unlocking? Post. Okay, so the simple change we have made, and let us check whether your deadlock problem can be solved with this or not. So compile it again, gcc dp1.a.out. Okay, now we can clearly see there is a progress, because if one is acquiring the chopsticks, another is remaining in the waiting state, and all the philosophers are completing their eating. Philosopher 0 is starting here, philosopher 1 is starting here, philosopher 2 have started here. So philosopher 2 is the first one to start the eating. Then philosopher 3 have started here. So once P2 releases, P3 will start. And once P3 releases, P4 will start. Once P4 releases, P0 will start. And after releasing of P0, P1 will start eating. Okay, so every time when you will take this output, you will get a different output. So in this way, we have solved the problem of deadlock also. So if you want to take a screenshot of this, let me take you to the program so that you can take a screenshot of it and can implement on your own. Okay, so first function is a main function. So this is a main function. I have written the comments wherever required. So you can copy these comments also so that you will understand what you are doing. So this is a complete function, main function, integer main. Initialize the semaphore variables, print the heading of the table, then next create the threads and join the threads. Okay, then next is a philosopher function. So in philosopher function, what we are doing, we are first converting a long int data type. So you can take this screenshot here. So first we are converting a number into an integer value. Then we are wherever the state is changing, we are just changing the character array, status num equals to h, status num equals to e, status num equals to t, and so on. Then the first we are locking the critical section before acquiring the chopstick. Then we are acquiring the chopstick. So this slip one we have used to just demonstrate a deadlock only. Later you can remove this also, it will not make any difference. And then after acquiring the chopstick, change the status to e. Then print the status. Every time when status is changing, we are printing the status also. And then release the chopstick, unlock the critical section, and print a status array, and finally exit the thread. Okay, so this is your philosopher function. And last function is print status function, which is simple. You have to just print by adjusting the spaces, adjust the spaces so that it should look like a table. Okay, so thank you for listening to the lecture.